Hey guys, how are you? I hope you've had a good day so far. This is about 4 something in the evening right now. And I've actually not done a lot today. Yesterday I wrote a couple of blogs. Today I've been a little lousy. I mean, do you realize that sometimes we're just energetic, sometimes we're not that energetic. I mean, somehow there's a varying degree of emotions that we feel on a day-to-day basis, and especially when we're trying to do something new, there's a lot of volatility in emotions that we go through, and it's not easy. All of this is not fucking easy. All right, so none of us said that following your dreams is easy, but even finding your happiness is easy. It's not easy. It's fucking tough. But do we have an alternative is the question. Do we have an alternative to finding our happiness in this world? That's the question. In fact, you know, people say that following your dreams is difficult. But think about it. Think about the alternative. The alternative is not following your dreams. The alternative is going to jobs that you don't like and thinking all your life inside your mind that it might have been. So, and that leads to perhaps the most negative of all emotions that there is, and it's guilt. I think guilt is the most negative of all emotions. It's not even fear. Fear is not the most negative emotion. Fear is still manageable. The problem with guilt is that guilt cannot be managed. Guilt keeps eating you inside because you've done something that you do not find a way to repair. That's what guilt does to you. Alright, so avoid guilt no matter what happens. Figure out how to live a life where you have less or even zero guilt as much as possible. At this point, am I guilty about something? I don't know. I've tried to live a life where I am not guilty about anything. I've tried to give my best to my life. I've tried to find happiness. I've tried to not be painful to people deliberately. I've not broken relationships. So I'm not guilty. I may have been not quite effective in certain situations, but I'm not guilty. My conscience has always been clear. Alright, cool. So we're reading Happiness in Your Skin. I think that was just a brief. I think it's nice to just like start talking about the day before we start making these videos. It just makes sense because anyways these videos are about life, right? So it just makes sense that we talk about life. And I just think I moved my pen. Alright, cool. So let's read. So we're reading the chapter Positivity is Indispensable. And we've read half of it, and I was saying yesterday that positivity is indispensable, and we can't really live without optimism. Optimism is a prerequisite to a happy life, and we can't be happy without positivity, without optimism. You could be in the worst of circumstances, and if you have a positive mental outlook, you would survive. And you could be in the best of circumstances and you have a negative outlook, you will not survive. You will take your life to misery. John Milton said, and I think I mentioned it somewhere. John Milton is not there in this chapter. Yeah, John Milton said that the mind is its own place. The mind is its own place, and in itself, it can make heaven of hell and hell of heaven. And I'm sure all of us know people who are able to make hell of heaven. And we also know a few people who are able to make heaven of hell. So it is quite a lot about attitude. So people who can make heaven of hell are to be sought after. People who learn how to make the best of their circumstances are truly happy. All right, cool. So if you are in a positive state of mind, you might say, oh, what if the glass is half full? Let me fill it up. That was a joke. And that's where we ended yesterday. But do you get it? You have the ability to believe whatever you would like to believe about life. You have the ability to believe whatever you would like to believe about life. So that's the thing about beliefs. Beliefs are assumptions. Beliefs are not necessarily true. Beliefs are not facts. Beliefs are not necessarily true. Beliefs are largely assumptions that we make about lives. And we could make good assumptions or we could make bad assumptions. and the quality of our lives will be determined to a lot of extent by the quality of our beliefs. If you believe you're capable of something, you will go after it. If you believe you're not capable of something, you will not do it. So, a lot of things are determined by belief. I actually wrote a post about it on my blog, and I think one of the most important things that all successful people have found meaning and happiness in their lives. I heard Sam Altman. Sam Altman is a guy based in Silicon Valley. He runs a company called OpenAI, and he has a blog called Sam Altman blog. You can Google it. And he says in his blog that one of the qualities of the most successful people in the world is a extremely high level of self-belief. He mentions a story where he went to visit Elon Musk at his factory in the initial days of SpaceX. Space Exploration is a company that's Elon Musk runs, and he's been sending rockets on behalf of NASA to the space station. And he says when he went to visit Elon Musk at his factory, one of the things that came striking to his mind was that Elon Musk had extremely high level of self-belief. So nobody who's ever achieved anything in this world has ever achieved it without high level of self-belief. The problem is that it's very difficult to achieve your dreams and make them come true. And a lot of people will tell you on the way that you can't do it. In fact, most of the society will actually tell you that you can't do it, because most people don't even ever give a shot at their dreams, right? So a high level of self-belief is extremely important, not just for positivity, but also to be able to achieve anything worthwhile in life, right? So if you have a job and you like it, you should be happy, as per Gallup's 2017 poll, which said that 85% people in the world hate their jobs. Gallup did a survey. Gallup is the world's foremost survey agency. They do a lot of data on people around the world. And Gallup did a survey in 2017 where they interviewed people around the world, and the conclusion was that 85% of people in the world hate their jobs. 85%. That's a mind-boggling figure. 85% people don't like their jobs. Imagine they so and I have a figure for you that if you hate your job, if you are part of the 85%, then you're actually wasting 5/7 of your life, which is about 70%. 5/7 is 5 days of the week when you go to office, and you're wasting 5/7 of your life, which is 71% of your life. If you are in the 85% to start with, you should be working to find a job you like. While you do that, you have every reason to be grateful for your education and your ability to improve your life. There's no reason your life won't improve if you work on it. But a lot of people don't even have the benefit of education, which can allow them to think and understand what they could do to improve their lives. Optimism is necessary so we can be satisfied to some extent about our current situation in life, while we try to take their satisfaction to a far higher level. Let me repeat that. Optimism is necessary so we can be satisfied to some extent about our current situation in life, while we try to take their satisfaction to a higher level. Eventually, we shouldn't only be satisfied with our lives, we should be happy with it. Satisfaction is boring term and not ambitious enough. Optimism makes life a little easier to bear. There's no reason to beat around what the hell is there in my mouth, sorry. Optimism makes life a little easier to bear, right? There's no reason to beat about your head about every problem that you're facing. It makes things worse. Optimism puts you in a frame of mind where you can solve problems. If you're in a disturbed state of mind, you can't even think straight about solutions. Like, think about it. Like, when you're tense about something, it fucks up the entire situation. If you have a problem and you're trying to solve the problem, you need a positive mental outlook to be able to think about the solution to the problem. But if you end up fucking your mind up and causing stress to your mind, you'll not even be able to think about a solution. Because to be able to think creatively about the problems of our life and to be able to find solutions, we need a positive mental outlook. Optimism makes our present and past bearable. Optimism makes our present and past bearable. You need to put your life in context, and that's where optimism helps. If you can be optimistic, you will realize that you were born without anything. If you can be optimistic, you'll realize that we were born without anything, and we have come so far. Yeah, that's nice. That's a nice line, right? Allow me a cup of tea. I really like tea. I think tea is one of the biggest blessings of life. let's not digress. So, if you can be optimistic, you'll realize that you were born without anything. You've come so far. So, if you're watching this video, you have the benefit of the internet, the education that you had, the ability to improve your life. So there's so much you have achieved so far in your life that you're not born with. You worked hard for it. You worked hard to study. You worked hard to clear school, college, wherever, whatever you studied. And you reached a certain point in your life so far. So you have come so far already. There's a reason to feel good about yourselves. You can be optimistic about the future. Since you've had a past that was cared for, practice gratitude every day. I know I'm not the only person saying it, but some lessons are just worth repeating over and over. Be grateful for the roof on your head. Be grateful for your parents and the education they accorded to you. Be grateful for what you've learned about life. Be grateful for your health and take care of it. Be grateful for the money you earn. Be grateful for the food on your table. Be grateful for the company with whom you enjoy that food. Be grateful. You realize that there's just so many things that you can be grateful for if you try. Negativity saps our physical, mental, and emotional energies. It puts us in a state of mind where we can only feel bad about our lives. Why would you want to do that? You need to feel good about life. Make sure you do a few things every day which make you feel good about your life. Never let a day go by without doing something you like. If you have to do 100 things or activities in a day, try to do as many as you like. If your job involves doing 80 boring tasks, you can still do 20 interesting tasks while trying to convert those 80 into something interesting at a future point. It may not happen overnight, but it'll happen if you keep trying. It is in the interest of organizations, by the way, and bosses to have people doing things they like. So convince them that you'll do a great job at certain tasks that you enjoy if you're allowed to do them. Take initiative and ask. If they don't let you, leave. Find something better. At home, if you have to do 20 tasks a day, make sure you divide it and see that you can do as many as you like. That's how you stay positive while trying to improve your life to take to the next level of joy. Optimism is like a seed. Optimism is like a seed. You have to plant it and water it every day. Practice optimism consciously. Watch your thoughts and quickly replace negative thoughts with positive ones. Because thoughts are things in no time. Alright, so we'll look at the summary of the chapter because we finished this chapter. And this is perhaps, it may sound as a cliche chapter when I really think about it. But then it is an important cliche. It is an important cliche. Optimism is a habit that you need to inculcate if you are to bring happiness into your life. We can't be happy without an optimistic attitude to life. Negativity saps our energies and puts us in a terribly unproductive state. Positivity makes us feel good about our current state of life while allowing us to work towards the future. If you have a negative state of mind, you can't work on the edifice of joy. Alright, so that's where we end this chapter and this video, and I hope it helps you find a positive outlook towards life. Positivity is indispensable. No matter where you are in life, you could be on the street or you could be living in a palace right now. If you are positive and optimistic, you will feel happier. Simple as that. There's no doubt about that. Alright, thanks. Bye.